This video is brought to you by Skillshare, an online learning community that offers thousands of inspiring and perfectly curated classes on multiple topics, including illustration, design, photography, video, freelancing, and much more, and helps creative and curious people all over the world to explore new skills and to take the next step in their creative journey. I will tell you more about the classes I took on Skillshare this week later in this video. And now let's go and repaint some dolls. Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. Well guys, today we will finally, really finally, we will make the Lady Dimitrescu doll. Why finally? Well, I will tell you now. It's gonna be the complaining episode of Pop and Atelier. I've decided to make this doll, the Lady Dimitrescu, back in May, or when it was in April, immediately after the game The New Resident Evil came out. I was completely amazed by this character, really, I don't have to explain you why, because she's just mesmerizing, really, her outfit, the look, the whole, like, image of the character. She's just absolutely stunning. My mom immediately made an outfit, really, fantastic outfit, super detailed. She even looked how all the buttons are made on the back of her outfit in the game. Everything was made so precise, correct, and detailed, really not normal. She shipped it, let's say, mid-May. On the 8th of June, the package arrived to Brussels. And that's it. That's it. From the 8th of June, this package was laying just somewhere there in their stock, or I don't know what, where, somewhere behind the closet probably. And now today I'm filming it, we are what, the 29th or the 28th, 29th of July today. I have suddenly, finally received the package. So it's really almost 2 months this box was just laying somewhere, yeah, behind the closet in Brussels. Unbelievable, because I went really already through all the stages from denial to complete accepting the fact that this outfit together with this beautiful hat that my mom made were just lost forever. And today suddenly such a beautiful surprise. I've got the box with this outfit and today we're finally, really, that's why I was saying finally, we're going to make the Lady Dimitrescu doll. Of course, the hype about the character is already a little bit went down, but anyway, I think she will stay iconic for a very long time, if not forever, because I think it's a really cool character. So I'm going to stop talking. I've complained about everything I was going to complain about, and now we're going to start working. Please guys, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. The next video normally will be in 2 weeks on Friday, or maybe the next week, no, probably in 2 weeks. But anyway, subscribe, hit the bell button to get notified about the new videos. Of course, support my art here on YouTube with your likes, and I'm going to start working. So, and as a model for this makeover, I will use this big 17 inches Monster High doll, because let's be honest, Lady Dimitrescu is a very tall lady. She's almost 3 meters or a little bit under 10 feet tall. So I think this is the perfect choice today. And this is actually the last big doll in my stock. Unfortunately, I was really lucky to keep her till now. So let's quickly do all the preparations, undress her, cut her hair off, all these things, and then we'll dive into the project. And you know, I really love these big 17 inches Monster High dolls. The only thing I truly hate about them is how hard their heads are. I have to blow hot air on it for a good 5 minutes probably, or even longer, before it becomes soft and removable. And even then, it's still not that easily removable, let's be honest. And also it can be very difficult sometimes to remove the rest of the short hair from the inside of these bigger dolls' heads. I had to even give up a couple of times after a couple of hours of suffering. So let's see what it will be this time. But no, this time it goes really easy. I have literally no explanation why sometimes it's impossible to pull it out and sometimes it just goes out like usually easy, it's okay, no problem, really, no idea. Okay, this step is done, now I'll put her body aside for a while, because I will need it later to make shoes and some other things. So I will wait a little bit with paint in it for now, and the face I'm going to cover with a couple of layers of light acrylics. After this, I'm covering her face with a couple of layers of Mr. Super Clear sealant. It will make the surface matte and quite paper-like. And I will be able to draw on it with watercolor pencils and also with soft pastels. So, first of all, I'm sketching her eyes, the lips, and then I will start working on her skin tone. And Lady Dimitrescu has a very, very pale skin. Well, she's a vampire, you know, it's normal. This is how we mostly imagine vampires. Very pale, living in the dark, that makes their skin tone not just very light, very pale, but also a little bit grayish. Pale, I don't know, it's almost like me sitting here home since March of the 2020, becoming very pale and grayish. Yeah, this is it. This is the tendency. Okay, so she has red lips, smoky eyes makeup, and she has yellowish eyes. And these are going to be our makeup goals for today. Thank you. Okay, this is the face. She looks already very good, but let's put it aside for a while, and now it would normally be time to work on her body. But as I said earlier, this is the last big doll in my stock, and I still really need this body to make a pair of shoes, sculpting them around her feet. And it's better to sculpt feet before painting and blushing the body, because if you first paint and blush and then you start making the shoes, there is a huge chance to damage the body, this paint. So we're going to start with making the shoes, and this is what we're actually going to do right now. Since Lady Dimitrescu wears a very long dress, there is not that much information regarding her shoes online, but it looks like she's wearing light shoes, kind of draped with folds of fabric. Looks interesting, let's make it. I begin with making basic shoes out of my beloved Warbler thermoplastic. Here everything goes quite like usually. I warm the thermoplastic up with a hairdryer, it becomes very soft and sticky. I can form different shapes out of it, and then Warbler cools down and becomes hard as the usual plastic again. Then I take a piece of natural silk and I glue it to the shoes, trying to cover them with the same folds of fabric like on that reference picture, trying to make it pretty. And this is what I've made so far. I don't know, it looks so good, even better than I expected. So now let's attach the soles and let's make high heels out of barbecue sticks. Then I cover the soles and the heels with acrylics to make them the same color. And guys, check it out, the shoes are finished. I don't know, they look super pretty. I've never tried this method of decorating shoes before, and I really love the end result, really super pretty. I don't know, maybe making shoes without seeing the outfit was a little bit too weird. And that's why let's switch now to my mom's work in progress video and let's watch her making the Lady Dimitrescu's outfit. You can see it now in the reference pictures. She wears a very long dress with this interesting draping on the front. The back of the dress looks also very, very special. I was first going to make the outfit myself, but then I saw the back of the dress and I kind of gave up and asked my mom to make it. So, and now you can see her working, trying to recreate the dress that has already become quite iconic. But of course, the hat of Lady Dimitrescu is even more iconic than her dress. I bet it will be one of the most popular looks the upcoming Halloween this year, really. And my mom has decided to make the hat as well using a piece of 100% wool felt. And she is going to make it around this plastic cap that perfectly fits the doll's head. And to make such a felt hat, you're supposed to soak the felt in very, very hot water. And then stretch it around the cup and let it completely dry like this, being stretched around this thing, around this construction. And then the next day, when my mom removes all this plastic, all this construction, she gets a perfectly formed hat. Check it out, really super. But right now this felt is still very soft, and to make it hard and kind of stable, my mom takes a hairspray and she sprays the hat to fix the end result. And when the hairspray gets completely dry, you get a very beautiful and very strong hat. So here they are, finally arrived to my studio, the dress and the hat. You can see the hat still looks absolutely perfect after all these weeks of sitting in the box somewhere in the post office. Really, it looks so pretty and so, I don't know, perfect and professional. It looks very real. And the dress is also absolutely legendary. I would never be able to make it myself with all these tiny details. Oh, not normal. My mom has made another best outfit ever. So now we can finally start working on her body, and first of all I want to add this retractable, how to call them, claw blades to one of her hands. This is one of the Lady Dimitrescu's special abilities, so I want to give it to my doll as well. And one hand will be like this, with these blades, and another one will be a regular hand. And I'm using Warbler thermoplastic to make it. While I'm busy with the claws, let's take a moment and let's talk about the sponsor of today's video, Skillshare. And this time, out of all these thousands of inspiring classes featured on the platform, I have chosen the one that is called AR for Artists, Create Your Own Face Filters by Sarah Tan. Because I felt like trying something completely new this time. You know, I have zero experience working with augmented reality, and I've never even thought about creating my own face filters for Facebook and Instagram, so this class felt like a very interesting challenge to me. And you know, Sarah explains everything really well. First of all, she gives you an idea of how AR works, shows you how to work with the Spark AR program, and also how to turn your artwork into face filters. So, you know, even though I started this class as a complete beginner, really zero, ground level, now you can see my first face filter made after following just 1 hour class. The heart-shaped glasses are changing their color when I blink, and there are also hearts flying out of my head. I don't know, doesn't look bad at all to me for the very first AR filter. Well, and if you want to try Skillshare, they have a very special offer for you this summer. The first 1,000 of my subscribers to click the link in the description box under this video will get a 1 month free trial of Skillshare Premium, instead of 2 weeks you could get before. So you can start exploring your creativity already today and decide later if you want to continue. So thank you so much, Skillshare, for sponsoring this video, and now let's go back to the claws. Okay, the claw blades look very good, so now we can sand this doll's body with nail buffers to make it matte, to remove this gloss from the top of the surface, and then we'll paint it with acrylics and blush it with pastels, the same like we already done to her face. Thank you. The hands together with the blades I'm covering with black acrylics. And the blades I still want to cover with silver metallic leaf to make them more blade looking. Okay, the body is finished, I think, and we can finally move on to her hairstyle. If you remember, the last week I showed you this amazingly pretty alpaca hair. Part of the blonde hair I gave to my Billie Eilish doll, and the dark hair I ordered especially for my Lady Dimitrescu, because I don't know, I think she deserves this premium quality extra hair. So now I'm going to take tacky glue and I will attach this hair to the hat. Now when the glue gets dry, I can brush her hair and then we can start styling it. Guys, if I haven't forgotten anything, right now I just have to attach false lashes, add glossy varnish to her eyes and lips, and then I guess we will be able to take a look at the end result pictures. And here is finally my Lady Dimitrescu doll. You cannot even imagine how happy I am to see her standing here in her beautiful outfit that was nearly lost and then found back again. Really, it was some detective story. And this is, you know, this is such a pretty outfit. It would be such a pity if it was just lost without a trace somewhere. Because I really think that this is one of the prettiest outfits my mom ever made. And it also looks exactly like the outfit on the reference picture, so it's just perfect. The hat is also another masterpiece created by my mom. You know, she loves making new and interesting things, not just sewing dresses. So I think we will still see some interesting hats and maybe some other accessories in the future made by my mom. And you know, also in general, I think this is one of the coolest dolls I've ever made. She looks absolutely gorgeous and also very dark. This project, of course, has very strong Halloween vibes, but anyway, I don't mind it. It's time to prepare for Halloween specials anyway, already for me. My mom already shipped the first Halloween outfit, by the way, to be sure it won't stuck somewhere for 2 months like this one. It would be very sad if it arrives somewhere before Christmas. So guys, now tell me please everything what you think about this project. I'm always curious to hear what you think. And this doll is now available for sale on eBay like always. You can find the link in the description box under this video. The doll will be there till Monday, so check it out if you need a scary vampire lady in your house. So, and that was the doll transformation of the week, guys. I really hope you enjoyed it today. And if so, please don't forget to support my art here on YouTube with your likes. Of course, subscribe to my channel, hit the bell button. And I will see you already very soon in 2 weeks in my new doll repaint video. Love you guys. Bye.